are here. I was just studying, because this is my study where I study things, two leaves that I found on a tree while I was walking around my neighborhood. I looked this up, and it's from something called the tulip tree, but it's sometimes called the duck feet tree. Can you tell why? These leaves look like pitter-patter, pitter-patter, quack-quack, duck feet. I thought that was really funny, and I wanted to share it with you. But since you're here, let's read what we're going to do today. It says, today we will sing a song. Oh, and today's message is from a little mouse, and her name is Tatiana Twitch Whiskers. She says, today we'll sing a song. We're going to read a book called Whoops by Suzi Moore. Oh, I usually say whoops when I mess something up, so I wonder what gets messed up in this story. And number three, we are going to make something super powerful. Can you tell what it is? Mm-hmm. And that will play an important role in today's story today. All right. But first, like Tatiana Twitch Whiskers says, it's time to do a song. And it's a country music song. In this song, we're going to clap our hands, stomp our feet like we have some really big boots on. We're going to wave hello, and then we're even going to bounce up and down. All right, you ready? Here we go.
You know, it's so much fun to clap, but sometimes it's hard to wait. We clap our hands when we get together, clap our hands to celebrate. Clap our hands when we get together, my friends and I can hardly wait.
Hold it right there. We're gonna wait.
To stamp our feet when we get together, to stamp our feet to celebrate, stamp our feet when we get together, my friends and I can hardly wait.
Hold it on one foot.
Woo! To wave when we get together.
Well, hey everybody, how you doing? It's so great to see you. Thanks for coming.
To bounce up and down when we get together, bounce up and down to celebrate, bounce up and down when we get together, my friends and I can hardly wait.
Hold it on one foot again if you can. It's a long wait.
To clap our hands when we get together, clap our hands to celebrate, clap our hands when we get together, my friends and I can hardly wait.
Great song. Friends, I'm going to bring you closer so you can see the pictures in the book and read those while I read the words. Here we go. Alrighty. So like I said earlier, the title of today's book is Whoops! And it looks like there's some bolts of lightning and thunder and there's a little dog and a little mouse, and a little cat. I wonder what is going wrong here and why the title is Oops. Let's read and find out. Oh, and there's our little mouse. Looks like Mouse was just reading a book. And, a knocked over chair. Some abandoned knitting. And one women's black high-heeled boot. I wonder what happened here. Whoops! Things looked all topsy-turvy in that last scene. Ah, let's meet the characters. Cat, dog, and mouse. This is the cat. Everyone say, hi, cat! This is the cat who didn't know how to sound like a cat. She couldn't say... We know what cats say. Meow! But is this cat saying anything at all? Nope. And this is the dog who couldn't bow wow. He couldn't say woof. He didn't know how. And we all know mice are supposed to say squeak, but nothing. Let's find out what's wrong with mouse. This is the mouse who tried to speak. She opened her mouth, but she couldn't say squeak. None of them can make the sounds that they need to make. None of them can speak.
So they go to see the wise owl.
An owl tells them,
"Find the old lady in the tumbledown house," said the owl to the cat and the dog and the mouse.
"She will have a spell to make you all well." Oh, so they're going to go to the tumbledown house and get some of that old lady's magic. She has a spell that will make them well. So they went down the lane and they went through the wood.
And the mouse would have squeaked if only she could. How do you think the mouse is feeling there in the deep, dark wood?
Yeah, the dog and the cat, they look pretty spooked, too. And look, there. There's the tumbledown house. What do you notice about it?
It's all beat up. Some of the boards are coming off. But you know what else I see? How can we tell that someone lives there? There's a little light on, and see up in the chimney? Some smoke is coming out.
All right, let's be brave. Let's go into that tumble-down house. At the heart of the wood was the tumble-down house. And so in went the cat and the dog and the mouse. Oh, and look who lives in there. The little old lady. The little old lady, on seeing the three, said, "I've heard of your problem. Oh, yes. Goodness me. Let me find you a spell that will make you all well."
This is a powerful part. Are you ready?
She went to look at her big spell book. She cast a spell and the whole house shook. And the wind blew in. And the rain came down, and the tumble-down house turned around and around. All right, let's see if it worked. And the cat said, "Cluck!" Wait a minute. And the dog said, "Quack!" And the mouse in a shoe said, and the little old lady, she said, "Whoops."
Can you say it?
Whoops. She made a mistake. None of these are right. Oh, silly me. Let's try page 3. That could be the spell that will make you all well. Now, I also want to point out, what color is the old lady's hair here?
It's orange. But when we first came in, did you see what color it was? It was blue. So it looks like she mixed up all their sounds and changed the color of her hair.
All right, let's try again. So she went to look at her big spell book. She cast a spell and the whole house shook. There was a flash and a crash and a rumbling sound, and the tumble-down house turned around and around. Right, let's see if she fixed it. Let's also look at the color of her hair. Well, the cat said, "Bah!" Oh no. And the dog said, "Nay!" And the mouse by the shoe said, "Moo, moo, moo." Uh-oh, all wrong again. And the little old lady said, "Whoops." Oh, good heavens. Shall we try page 7? That could be the spell that will make you all well. And do you see how she's casting all these spells? There's her tiny little wand. It looks like it was one of her knitting needles that she was knitting with earlier. One of the knitting needles is a magic wand. Her hair is purple now. All right. This looks like a really powerful spell. Are you ready? So she went to look at her big spell book. And she cast a spell and the whole house shook. There was a bang and a clang and a thundering sound. And the tumble-down house turned around and around. Whew. And the cat said, woof. And the dog said, squeak. And the mouse, and the dog said, squeak. And the mouse, meow, said the mouse, when she tried to speak. So are these right? Cats don't say woof. Dogs don't say squeak. Mice don't say meow. But we're getting closer here, right? Maybe she should try one more spell. And the little old lady, we can only see her legs, said, whoops. We can't even see her hair there. Oh, no, not again. Let's try page 10. That must be the spell to make you all well. Uh-oh. This looks like her craziest spell yet. She's really using all her power here. She went to look at her big spell book. She cast a spell and the whole house shook. There was a sparkle and a crackle and a thundering sound. There was a flash and a crash and a rumbling sound. There was a bang and a clang. Looks like they're all running away. And the sky turned brown. The wind blew in and the rain came down. And the tumble-down house turned around and around. Let's see if this works. And when it landed, the cat said, meow! And the dog said, woof! And when the mouse tried to speak, she said, squeak, squeak, squeak! And the little old lady said, croak. Oh no, do you see what happened here? She fixed all the animals. But what's the big whoops here? The little old lady turned herself into a frog with blue hair. And the wise old owl who was watching from a tree looked down with a frown, and he said to the three, whoops. So now the owl is using the words that the old lady should use. Wow, what a fun, silly story. Now, that takes us to number three. I'm going to show you how you can make a powerful magic wand like the old woman used in the story. Now, her magic wand was one of her knitting needles. I use something different, although you can use any stick. We did the not a stick lesson, I think maybe last week. And so I went out in my yard and I found another stick to turn into a magic wand. Let me show you what mine looks like. I have it here in my wand holder. All right. So I got a stick. And I wrapped it up with yarn. And then at the top of the stick, you'll need a magic object. Now, some people just want to cut out a paper star, but I encourage you to look at maybe some of the plants around your house. Plants are very powerful and very magical. Can you tell what part of the plant I've used here? It's a tomato vine, and I thought the tomato vine looked like magic leaping stars. So I tied it to the end of my stick, and I put some string on the end to make me really be able to zap things. All right, should we practice casting some spells together? Let me look up the words that the old woman used. Let's see. Okay, let me get ready to do some magic. So, she went to look at her big spell book. And she cast a spell and the whole house shook. The wind blew in and the rain came down. And when Stephanie came back, She had the hair of a clown. Oh no. Let me try this again. Where's my wand? This will not do. This will not do. So, she went to look at her big spell book. And she cast a spell. And the whole house shook. The wind blew in and her nose started to itch. And Stephanie came back with the hair of a witch! Oh no, oh no, where's my wand? This will not do, this will not do. So she went to look at her big spell book. She cast a spell and the whole house shook. The wind blew in and there was a strange stink. And when Stephanie came back, her hair was all pink. Oh, wow. Hey, everybody. I really like this. I don't think I'm going to change it. All right. I'm going to go practice some more spells with my magic wand. And I hope you have fun making a magic wand of your own. All right, hopefully you don't have as many oops moments as the old lady in the story. I will be back soon with another great story for you. See you later.